Today I'm going to talk about the relationship between conditions very early in life and healthy aging. Now, population aging is the greatest demographic trend of our times. The population is aging, and the share of people age 65 and older is rapidly increasing in all countries. In the Netherlands today, about 18% of the population is above age 65, and this proportion is forecast to increase to 26% by 2040. It means that in 2040, a bit more than at least one out of four people is going to be age 65 or more. Now, population aging obviously puts pressure on the social security system and imposes costs for the healthcare system. Indeed, it is true that we do live longer, but the fact that we do live longer does not imply that we live longer in good health. Therefore, if you want to turn population aging from a challenge into an opportunity, we need to promote healthy aging. Now, indeed, the challenge of healthy aging is not too much adding years to life, but it is adding life to years, so that when we grow up, we can be all like these rocking grannies over here. Now, however, if we want to study healthy aging, one thing which is very important to understand is that healthy aging is not a state. Healthy aging is a lifelong process, which actually starts at birth, and even before birth, even before conception. So healthy aging is not about that old lady over there, but it is about all of us. It is about me, it is about you, it is about all of us and our children. So healthy aging starts at birth. It's a lifelong process. And indeed, in this presentation today, I'm going to focus on the baby over there. And I'm going to show you how conditions, even very early in life, at birth and during the pregnancy of the mother, can have a long-lasting effect on health and mortality. Now, the idea that early life conditions can have an effect on health even very late in life was put forward for the first time in the medical science. So the fetal programming hypothesis and the developmental origins hypothesis basically state that deprivation in the womb can actually cause alterations in some vital organs, and these alterations in turn are going to have a positive effect on short-term survival, but they are going to have a negative effect in the long run. Actually, after this idea came up, there have been studies in many different fields. Usually in demography and in epidemiology, people study the association between early life indicators, such as birth weight, and health late in life. While in economics and sociology, we look more at the association between socioeconomic status and income early in life and late life health. Now, so in this presentation, I'm going to try to bring insights from different disciplines together to show how the state of the economy at birth can have an effect on mortality and health late in life. So why should the state of the economy at birth have an effect on health and mortality late in life? Well, say that we are in a recession like the one that we just experienced. So what happens when there is a recession? Income is lower for many people. There might be a problem of lack of nutrients and good living conditions for at least some pregnant women and some infants. And the stress level of the population is also going to be high. And the stress level might be high not only for the people who are directly affected by the crisis and they lose their job, but also for those who are not directly affected by the crisis. They don't lose their job, but the uncertainty in the environment can still cause an increase in the stress level. Now, if we believe the fetal programming hypothesis, then this will have an effect on health late in life. So how do we measure the state of the economy at birth and during pregnancy? There are different ways to do so, but one that is used usually in the literature is to look at the unemployment rate. Now, so anybody here born at the beginning of the 80s in the Netherlands, though? Well, not too many. Richard, I know, also here. Okay, so actually, you're not going to like this presentation then. indeed, actually, this graph shows the unemployment rate in the Netherlands from 1950 to 2015. And as you can see, actually, the unemployment rate in the Netherlands was pretty high at the beginning of the 80s after the second oil crisis. And it was high also recently due to the recent financial crisis. But as you can see, in the Netherlands hit a little bit later than in other countries. Now, so several studies have looked at the relationship between the state of the economy at birth and especially mortality late in life. And these very interesting studies have found that actually indeed being born in a recession has a negative effect on mortality. And if we look at cause-specific mortality, it has a negative effect especially on cardiovascular disease-related mortality. Now, one short, this is also consistent with epidemiological studies. Now, one shortcoming, actually two shortcomings of these studies are, first, they look at mortality, but mortality has the advantage of being an objective indicator, so we know whether somebody is dead or not. However, it doesn't say anything about the quality of life of people before dying. And remember, we want to focus on adding life to years rather than adding years to life. And the second is that because we have to focus on people who have already died, obviously these studies focus on relatively older generations. And the situation might be different now when the social welfare system is also different. So a new ongoing research projects that actually exploit something unique that we have here, the Lifelines data, that collect data from the three northern provinces of the Netherlands, and also blood samples and questionnaire about the people in the northern of the Netherlands. We are looking at the effect of the state of the economy at birth, not on mortality, but on some biomarkers. So what are biomarkers? Biomarkers are objective medical indicators of the presence of or severity of a disease state. And actually, although the results are still very preliminary, actually we do find an effect, a negative effect of being born in a recession on some of these biomarkers, especially the ones which are related to cardiovascular disease risk. And indeed, again, this is consistent with what is found in epidemiological studies. So does this matter? Now, you might think that I decided to focus on birth because I'm on maternity leave, as Richard said, and so I was preparing this presentation while changing diapers, and all I could think of was babies, babies, babies. But actually, it's more important than that. From a public health perspective, it's really important because it's very crucial. Because we want to design, if early life conditions have an effect on health late in life, we want to be able to design suitable policies and intervention in order to prevent the transmission of bad conditions at birth on health late in life, and reduce also socioeconomic inequalities in health that we know are still persistent also today. So to conclude, I have two take-home messages. First, healthy aging really starts at birth. Second, healthy aging is very complex, and if we want to understand it, we really need a multidisciplinary approach. And we need to join forces together to put together the pieces of the puzzle. And I would like to thank you for your attention.